So what is kennel cough? Kennel cough is a kind of a broad term that encompasses any type of canine infectious respiratory process. It can be viral, it can be bacterial, and it can be a combination of both. But generally when we see this is when people either travel or leave their dog in an area that it has a lot of other dogs in close proximity. Poor ventilation can attribute to it, but usually it's a direct contact thing or very close to direct contact where droplets and air exchange through respiration is occurring. There are vaccines for kennel cough, the broad term kennel cough. It does not hit all of them, but for the most part, it's going to hit the Bordetella species and subspecies of Bordetella bronchiseptica. There's other viral ones that are kind of with influenza, parainfluenza, and these can occur at the simultaneously or independently of one another. What we're seeing with kennel cough is coughing, especially if you had a dog prior to going to a facility around other dogs, picking them up, and now they're coughing. The type of cough that we see can change, but usually it's more of a drier hacking cough that we would see starting out. And the coughing is what kind of exacerbates the issue over time, because the more turbulence, the more irritation to this airway creates a better environment for the infection to further set up. Obviously, it causes more irritation, which leads to more coughing, which leads to more inflammation. And so we get this cyclical thing that causes it to get worse. So the treatments for it are pretty straightforward. We want to suppress the coughing. We want to reduce the inflammation. And ideally, we want to treat the source of that infection. So getting on antibiotics, whether or not it is viral or bacterial, many times we're not going to go down that route of trying to culture it or figure out what it is, because treating it is, in kind of a broad sense, is usually going to be very effective. Now, there are cases where the dogs can get very bad and they may need to be hospitalized. They may need to be in supportive oxygen care. But if we can intervene before that, we can minimize the cost of the treatment and hopefully avoid hospitalization by getting on top of it. So once you notice these signs and symptoms after picking up your dog, get them to your veterinarian. They may choose a broad range of antibiotics. They may choose to do some type of a minor corticosteroid to help reduce inflammation, likely some type of a cough suppressant. But left untreated, it can get worse, especially if it starts to set up and we get some fluid and inflammation in the lungs themselves. So treatment duration varies on the severity of the infection. Obviously, catching it earlier, we can have results much quicker. If it goes untreated and gets worse, then it can take longer. I would say on average, I see treating kennel cough, most people catch it early, anywhere between 5 to 7 days, we'll see resolution of clinical signs. But many times, just to cover the bases, that course of antibiotics will extend past that, and you'll want to finish out that prescribed course and duration of antibiotics, not stopping them early just because you see the results. We want to knock that infection out through the duration of that prescribed antibiotic course. Yeah, so avoiding Bordetella can be hit or miss because we know that the vaccine for Bordetella does not hit all of the possible subspecies that there are. And some of the data even shows that the vaccine itself is about 50% effective. That doesn't mean don't get it. If you are going to a kenneling facility, most of them require that vaccine, but that vaccine can help significantly improve your chances of not getting that infection. But it really depends on the other animals that are at that location. It's highly contagious and it spreads like wildfire.